will see exercise 13.2. Question number 1. A solid is in the shape of cone standing on a hemisphere with both their radius being equal to 1 cm and the height of the cone is equal to its radius. Find the volume of the solid in terms of pi. Now let's see the solution. This is the shape consists of hemisphere and cone. The radius of a cone and its height is equal to 1 cm. So both the radius and height will be 1 cm. And as their base is same, so the hemisphere will also have radius equal to 1. We will write the values over here for cone and for hemisphere. Now, the volume of the whole solid is volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. Yes, by putting the formula over here, volume of cone is 1/3 pi r square h and volume of hemisphere is 2/3 pi r cube. Substitute the value, all the values like r and h are 1. We solve it. So for cone, we will have 3 pi by 3, and for hemisphere, we will have 2 pi by 3. So here 3 is our LCM, so we will add them 3 pi. So 3 pi in denominator and numerator, 3 will cancel. Pi is the your answer. So pi centimeter cube your final answer. Now come to question number 2. Richard, an engineering student, was asked to make a model shaped like a cylinder with two cones attached at its two ends by using a thin aluminium sheet. The diameter of the model is 3 cm. See, diameter is given 3 cm. And the length is 12 cm. 12 cm is the whole height of the cylinder of this model. Cylinder including these cones. If each cone is of height 2 cm, means this cone end part, the cone is given at the end part of this model. So its height is 2 cm for both. We have to find out the volume of air contained in that model. So we have to find out the volume of this model. Yes. For that, first of all, we think which shapes are included in this model. Yes. Two cones and one middle part that is composed of cylinder. Okay, so first of all we see the values of this cone and cylinder. So this, it is said that the diameter is given is 3 cm. So radius is 3 by 2 and the height of the cone is given 2 here and 2 here. So from this 12, the total height of this model, 4, that is 2 plus 2 will minus, and the height for cylinder will remain 8 cm. Understood, friend? Let's see other details of the question. Now the height of the cone is given, is termed as H1, that is equal to 2 cm, and height of the model is total 12 cm. From that we will minus 4, so the height of the cylindrical part is 8 cm. Now the radius of cylinder and radius of cone are equal, that is 3 by 2 cm. Now the volume of the whole model is volume of one cylinder, that is the middle part, and volume of cone that compose its end. So by putting the formulas for volume of cylinder here and volume of cone here, multiply by 2 because 2 cones are there. We substitute the values of R and H, radius and height. Finally, our answer will come 66 cm cube. Centimeter cube. Yes, friends. Let's see question number 3. A gulab jamun consists of sugar syrup up to 30% of its volume. Find the approximately how much syrup would be found in 45 gulab jamuns. Here number of gulab jamuns are given. Each shaped like a cylinder with two hemispherical ends. See friends, in question number 2 we have seen that there is a cylinder between and cone at both ends. Now in this question it is said that there is a cylinder, yes, but hemispherical end. So you know, in place of cone, now we have to put the formula for hemisphere. Yes, let's see the solution. See, this is the figure for the question. The total height is given 5 cm and the diameter is given 2.8 cm. So half of that is 4.1 cm, that is the radius for cylindrical part as well as for hemispherical part. Yes. Now from this distance is the radius of the hemisphere, that is 1.4, and this is same as 1.4. Understood? Now from this total length 5 cm, 1.4 left and right will deducted to find out the length for the cylinder. Yes. Let's see here. So from 5, 1.4, 1.4, 2 times we will subtract. So the height of the cylinder will come to 2.2 only. Understood, friend? Next, volume of this gulab jamun. One gulab jamun is, it is composed of one cylindrical part and two hemispherical part. So the volume of cylinder plus 2 into volume of hemisphere we will take. So same way we substitute the formula here, that is volume for a cylindrical part is pi r square h plus 2 into 2 by 3 pi r cube. This is hemispherical part, volume of hemispherical part. Yes, we can multiply this, so it becomes 4 by 3 pi r cube. Substituting the values, we will have answer of 1 gulab jamun, volume of 1 gulab jamun, that will be 25.05 cm cube. Now, you know there are 45 such gulab jamuns. So this value will multiply with 45. So we will have this value. This is the volume of total 45 gulab jamuns. Now, out of that volume, 30% is the sugar syrup. So 30% of this value, this total 45 gulab jamun, volume of 45 gulab jamun is the sugar syrup. If you solve these, so approximately your value will be 338 centimeter cube. That is your answer. Stop. Yes, friends, let's see question number 4. A paint sand made up of wood is in the shape of cuboid with 4 conical depression to hold paints. The dimension of the cuboid are 15 cm by 10 cm by 3.5 cm. Now the radius of each of the depression is 0.5 cm and the depth is 1.4 cm. Find the volume of the wood in the entire stand. Here one cubital part is given. Out of this cubital part we had made a paint stand. To hold the paint we have make a depression in the wooden part. So we have to find out the rest of the volume of rest of the part. So see, first of all we write all the data that is given in the question. The depth of each of the conical depression is 1.4 cm. The radius of each of the conical depression is 0.5 cm. The length of cuboid is 15 cm, breadth is 10 cm and height is 3.5 cm. Now you know, we have to find out the volume of wood required to make that paint stand. That is actually the volume of cuboid minus 4 into volume of cone, because there are 4 conical shape we have taken out from that solid part. So we write the formulas over here and substituting the values of the terms, we will have our answer 523.53 cm³. Yes friends, let's see next question. Question number 5. The vessel is in the form of inverted cone. Its height is 8 cm and the radius of its top which is open is 5 cm. It is filled with the water up to the brim. When the lid is on, each of which is a sphere of radius 0.5 cm, a drop into the vessel, 1/4 of the water flows out. Find the number of liters of water drop in the vessel. Yes, this is our vessel, conical shape, inverted conical shape. The value of this is are given, that is radius of this cone is 5 cm and height is 8 cm. Now we are dropping some lead salt, means marbles, in this. By that the water inside the vessel comes out. How much water comes out? 1/4 of the water, means whatever the water is there, 1/4 of that water comes out from the vessel. That means the volume of lead salt is equal to 1/4 the volume of this vessel. Yes. So first of all, we denote all the terms that is given in the question. Height of conical vessel, that is H, is 8 cm, and radius of the conical vessel, that is R1, is 5 cm. Now the lead salt is in the shape of a sphere, so the radius, that is R2 of the lead salt, is 0.5 cm given in the question. Now the number of lead salt that we assume as N, so our formula will become volume of water spilled out is the volume of water, volume of dropped lead salt. The number of lead salt that we drop, the total volume of that lead salt is equal to the water spill out. Yes, which implies the 1/4 of the volume of cone equal to N into, N is the number of lead salt multiplied by volume of lead salt, that is the volume of the sphere, 4/3 pi R³. Here we will take the R2, that is the radius of the lead salt. Yes, by substituting your values, we will have value of N here, that is 100. So the 100 lead salt we may drop in the conical vessel. Yes friends, yes friends. Let's see question number 6. A solid iron pole consists of cylinder of height 220 cm and base diameter 24 cm, which is surmounted by another cylinder of height 60 cm and radius 8 cm. Find the mass of the pole given that 1 cm cube of the iron has approximately weight 8 grams mass. Yes. Here the value of pi is given 3.14. So we have to use in that for in the formula. Yes, here two cylinders are given, and the value for that cylinders are also given. That is the upper part, the radius of that upper part is 8 cm and height is 60 cm, and the lower part height is 220 cm and total diameter is 24. So you know that the radius is the half of the diameter, that will be 12 cm. So first of all, we denote all the terms that is given in the question. The height of the larger cylinder, that is H1, is 220 cm. The radius 1, that is the radius of larger cylinder, 12 cm. Height of smaller cylinder, that is H2, 60 cm, and radius of smaller cylinder, that is R2, 8 cm. These are the values given in the question. Now here in the question it is said that the mass of given is 1 cm cube. This cube, you know that we have to find out the volume. Yes friends, so we have to find out the whole volume of this both the cylinders. So now total volume of the iron pole is volume of larger cylinder plus volume of smaller cylinder. So the volume of larger cylinder, formula for both is same, just the terms are different. So we will use different terms, that is R1 and H1, and for the second cylinder R2 and H2. Formula will be same. By substituting the terms, values in the terms, we will have our final answer, that is this. Now this is in centimeter, so we have to convert this centimeter cube into gram. So we know that 1 centimeter cube of iron is 8 gram, that is given in the question. So what about if this much volume is given. So by cross multiplying, we will have this is this answer in gram. So this is a very huge amount. So by dividing this gram with 1000, we can convert it into kilogram. So we will divide it by 1000 and our answer comes in kg.